Good day to all, dear subscribers and viewers of the channel. Vitaly Sokolov with you. Today we will talk about one of those engines that you may be advised for creating 2D games on various sites and forums of programmers if you program in Delphi, Pascal, or Lazarus. And before we start, don't forget to put your thumbs up under the video, subscribe to the channel, and write a comment. This is important for promoting the video. And also put a bell so that you receive notifications about new videos on the channel. ZenGL is a cross-platform game development library written in Pascal. This game engine provides the necessary functionality for 2D graphics output, input processing, sound playback, and more. The engine developer is Andriy Kemka, known as Andru, from Ukraine, the city of Zhitomir. Prior to that, he was the developer of the Omega GL engine. The development of the engine took place from about 2007 to 2013. The latest official version of the engine is 0.3.12. Further development of the engine is carried out by Sergey Shutkin from Russia, known as Seenkao. He added the green engine library to the engine, also added an independent input field, changed and accelerated the system for working with text, changed the processing of the keyboard, mouse, touchpad, added the ability to post rendering. The current version of the modified engine at the moment is 3.28. It is distributed on GitHub under the same free license called ZenGL. But with the old version of ZenGL, it is only partially compatible, and its capabilities have been expanded, and some, on the contrary, have become incompatible or have lost their functionality. In considering this material, we will stick to the official old version of the engine, but we will make corrections and compare these features with the new unofficial version of ZenGL. The engine supports Windows, Linux, Mac OS X, Android, iOS platforms. The new version supports Mac OS Cocoa, and work with iOS has not been tested. The following programming environments are supported: Delphi, Lazarus, Free Pascal. But the new unofficial version through the Delphi environment can only compile projects under Windows. Improvements are needed for the Android platform. Let's consider the main features of the official version of the engine. Working with graphics is implemented by means of the OpenGL library ability to use in the form of SO, DLL, DILib libraries and directly the source code. Rendering to both native and pre-prepared Windows. Event logging. Loading resources directly from files, memory and zip archives. Multi-threaded loading of resources. The ability to expand the number of supported data formats. Anti-aliasing, screen resolution, refresh rate and vertical sync control. Correction of the proportions of the displayed image relative to the specified dimensions. Controlling the title and size of the window, the presence of automatic centering. Controls the visibility of the cursor within the window. Handling keyboard, mouse and joystick events. Processing unicode text input. The ability to restrict input to the Latin alphabet. Supports SCSI, PNG, JPG and PVR formats. Correct work with NPOT textures. Filtering parameters management. Working with masks. The presence of render targets for rendering to a texture. Textural unicode fonts. Output formatted text in UTF-8 encoding. Controls indents, size, color of vertices and the number of characters in the text. Batch render to improve performance. Rendering of the main types of primitives. The presence of a sprite manager. Rendering static sprites, sprites with animation and tiles. Rendering the transforming mesh. Rendering sprites with manual indication of texture coordinates, with pixel dimensions and usually from 0 to 1. Controls blending and color mixing mode. Ability to assign color and alpha to individual vertices of sprites and primitives. Additional transformations of sprites, mirroring, increasing, offset of vertices. Fast clipping of sprites out of sight. The presence of a camera with the ability to increase and rotate the contents of the scene. Working with sound is carried out via Opinel or Direct Sound, depending on the build settings or OS, but in the new unofficial version of the engine, work with DirectX is not supported. Correct operation in the absence of a sound card. Supports WAV and AUG as samples. Streaming audio files. Controls the volume and playback speed settings. 3-dimensional positioning of the sound source. When working with video, the following options are available: decoding frames to texture, Theora codec support and AUG container. It is also possible, basic set of math helper functions, the required set of functions for triangulation, basic set of collision functions, working with INI files, helper functions for working with files and memory, During the existence of the engine, many games and programs have been created on it. I suggest you look at a small cut of such projects. From all that has been said previously, I propose to summarize. The advantages of this given engine are its minimalism in coding, the lightness of the engine itself, and its versatility and multi-platform nature. Games can be written both for personal computers and mobile platforms. The engine is also completely free. The disadvantages of this engine include the fact that the official version of the engine is no longer supported. An unofficial version of the engine is still developing, but it has become partially incompatible with the old version and has begun to support fewer operating systems. So you will have to choose which version suits you best for different projects. This engine is focused mainly on 2D games. Therefore, it is better to use other game engines for 3D projects. In general, I recommend this engine for creating 2D games. Quite good optimization and high development speed are the unambiguous advantages of the engine. That's all for me. If this video was interesting for you, do not forget to put your thumbs up under the video, subscribe to the channel, and write a comment. This is important for promoting the video. And also put a bell, so that you receive notifications about new videos on the channel. Good luck creating new games, and see you in the next videos.